September 2nd. Here's our Boeing 10 update. First, I'm sure you can hear it already. That wind is howling. But right now I'm heading out to go drop off carcasses out in the river here after playing up the fish. We ended up with 6 Chinook and 3 Coho. Let 3 other Cohos go. And I never really left about a half mile area. I stayed all over the Washington side above the bridge. There were plenty of people over there. And there was a decent bite. It sounded like up there above up there. A lot of guys got all their Chinook pretty quick, and I keep thinking that, you know, heck, there's a lot of coho moving in, because I keep hearing these little snaps that are taking place where guys are catching a few coho. You know, yesterday was down there at Buoy 10 and Marker 1, there were a lot of coho being caught. Yesterday, even up there at Tunk Point, I was catching a bunch of coho up there. But I talked to several other people, and, you know, a few guys didn't see a coho, didn't hook a single coho all day long. Right place, right time, right? So, you know, a lot of Chinook still being caught around here, and we're kind of thinking that maybe these Chinook will be flushing out of here now that the tides are starting to grow. They start making their way upriver, but it seems as though they're still hanging. So hopefully we can get maybe one more day at them. We'll see. As far as what works, anchovies and spinners both work pretty well. I was in fairly warm water all day long because these tides that just aren't too big quite yet. You know, they're still right around 6 foot. So I'm standing in that warmer water, that 68 to 70 degree river water. So having the spinner blades definitely helps. The little Hildebrandt blades have been working pretty good. I've even started putting them in front of my anchovies. I'm running anchovies. And that seems to work out pretty well too. The best flasher that worked today was definitely Pawn Shop. Now, usually Pawn Shop, in my opinion, does fairly well when it's early morning, get the marine layer, you get some cloud cover like for spring Chinook. That's when that one really seems to do well, for me at least. But today, man, it did work. And it did well yesterday too, but today it really did well with silver and pink Hildebrandt blade. And what was the other one? Red, white, and blue. I call it 1776. That blade did pretty well too behind Pawn Shop. So, you know, all in all, there's plenty of fish down here. What's kind of interesting is that, you know, it's a holiday weekend. It's not terribly crowded. And I know I'm probably going to hear it now. Well, of course, now it's going to get all crowded down here. Well, look, people have already made their plans to either come down here or not. But, you know, it's decent fishing, but it's not red hot. I'm still waiting on those coho to show up. We'll see. But I'm sure you can see it's starting to get a little rough out here already. Oh, there's a big wave coming. Oh yeah. Yep, this happens every time we get a tide change. And you get the outgoing tide that pushes against this west wind that comes in, this northwest wind. So that makes it pretty lumpy out here. And that's what we're seeing right now. We just hit high slack a little while ago, about an hour and a half ago. And now we're getting this wind pushing up against the tide. And it's just going to keep on getting bigger. So with that, I'm going to dump my carcasses, get back in, get all showered up, cleaned up, because tonight is an opener for the Ducks. Go Ducks. I know a lot of you guys don't like the Ducks, whatever. But it's my lump, so I have to cheer for it. All right, guys. We'll see you guys later. Lots of Chinook. 6 Chinook and 3 Coho for us. Released a few other Coho. Pawn Shop was the winner. Putting some blades in front of the anchovies helped. But we'll see what tomorrow brings. Every single day is different. All right, guys, later.